Introduction to the Delta-wye transformer connection, Part 7C. In this part, we're going to look at how the transformer connection is actually defined by the Dyn11 and then the DAC, which basically mean the same thing. Okay, so let's get to it. This type of a delta connection is often defined by DAC. This designation is mainly used in the United States, and how it works is very, very simple. What it's telling us is that the polarity side of winding A is connected to the non-polarity side of winding C. Let's draw that over here. So what we're saying is that the polarity side of winding A is connected to the non-polarity side of winding C. And once you've defined that pattern, the next pattern is that the polarity side of winding B, which is this side here, is connected to the non-polarity side of winding A. And the polarity side of winding C is connected to the non-polarity side of winding B. Now, if you're having a hard time understanding this pattern, all you have to do is just write AC here and then add the missing phasor, which is B, and then repeat the same thing over here, ACB. Okay, so the first pattern is this right here. So the polarity side of winding A is connected to the non-polarity side of winding C. This is the second pattern. And what we're saying is that the polarity side of winding B is connected to the non-polarity side of winding A. And this right here is a third pattern. And what we're saying is that the polarity side of winding C is connected to the non-polarity side of winding B. Okay, so another type of a delta connection is a DAB delta connection. And although it tells us how it's connected, it doesn't tell us what the phase relationship is between the high voltage winding and the low voltage winding. All this tells us is the connection. And then this designation of the Delta-wye transformer connection is very popular outside of the United States. This gives us a lot of information, but it's also very confusing at first. Okay, so let's break it down step by step. The capital D tells us that the high voltage winding is connected in delta. The lowercase y tells us that the low voltage winding is connected in y, okay? It's y or star, same thing. Because the N comes directly after the y, the N tells us that the low voltage winding's neutral bushing is available. Now, the low voltage neutral bushing is available, but that doesn't mean that the neutral bushing is actually grounded. Here's that neutral that I'm referring to. So this right here is that neutral. So it's telling us that the bushing is available, but it's not telling us that the neutral bushing is actually grounded or not. Okay. Now the last thing is this 11. And this right here is the source of all of our problems. The way that this is actually defined, well, first of all, there's not a lot of resources out there that explains step by step how this 11 designation actually works. And if it was described in these resources, it would be described as 11 increments of 30 degrees phase shift between the high voltage winding and low voltage winding. But my friends, this type of a description is extremely confusing. Well, at least to me, it was very confusing. The first question that really popped up into my head, which two quantities are they referring to when they say high voltage winding and low voltage winding? We have V phase A, right, on the high voltage side. We have VAB on the high voltage side. We have VAG on the high voltage side. So which quantities are they defining when they say the high voltage winding, okay? The other question that pops into my head is that these increments of 30 degrees, so they say 11 increments of 30 degrees, that equals 330 degrees. Which direction is this 330 degrees phase shift? For example, so let's say this ambiguous high voltage quantity was defined as A, right? Now we could go counterclockwise 330 degrees like that, and then that would be defined as the low voltage winding A. So we could go counterclockwise 330 degrees, okay? Or we could go clockwise 330 degrees like that, and then call that winding A, and then we have 330 degrees in that direction. So which direction are they actually talking about? Because based on the direction, we're gonna have two completely different phasors, right? So this 11 here introduces a lot of confusion. I think this is a pretty good place to stop. If you haven't subscribed already, please click on the bottom right corner of the screen. There should be a subscribe button. Please subscribe to this channel and share these videos with your friends and colleagues. And the other request that I have is, like me, I know there are people out there who question a lot of things about power systems in general. So if you have any questions, please go ahead and comment away in the section below. And of course, this tutorial was brought to you by GeneralPAC.com, making power system protection, automation, and controls intuitive.